from Hollywood, it's the Tom Likas Show.
I love it.
And now, here he is, Tom Likas. Thank you for tuning in to the Tom Likas Show. This is where America gets together to talk about the issues. You really care about. It's a different kind of radio talk program. We're the radio talk show that is not hosted by a right-wing wacko or a convicted felon. No! I am your host. Write down our toll-free telephone number. You're gonna need it. It's 1-800-5800-TOM. 1-800-5800-866. Thank you for tuning in. I've got 8 big TVs in my home, 7 plasma screens, and a drop-down screen that is 108 inches. It's 9 feet. 9 feet. That's in my bedroom, by the way. Have you ever seen pornography on a 9-foot screen? I got to tell you something. I don't know if that's a girl or the Holland Tunnel. I don't know what I'm looking at. Wow. It's outrageous. What a big screen. It's huge. There's nothing like watching sports at home or movies. To the point where, to be honest with you, last season, I saw more baseball games in Chicago than Los Angeles. Because I went to Chicago to meet my brother for the weekend. We went to Wrigley Field a couple of times. I saw more games at Wrigley Field than Dodger Stadium last year. Because when I'm home, I've got games on the big screen. Do I need to fight all the traffic and fight all the parking there? When I've got the screen so large, so many of the games are in HD, what am I doing? Same thing with movies. Are you kidding me? I mean, my drop-down screen isn't much smaller than screen 13 at the Beverly Center. It's not. So what am I, crazy? I could sit in bed with Dolby 5.1, a 9-foot HD television picture. Perfect. Do I want to drive to the mall, especially during the holiday season? I want to drive to the mall, pay to park, go to the theater, eat their crappy food, you know, pay $11 to $13 a ticket, in some cases $14 or $15 now in L.A. to see a movie. And I can't press the pause button or anything like that. Then I get inside the movie theater. And people now go to the movie theater like they're watching TV at home. They're sitting there talking, chatting on the phone, chatting on the internet through their cell phone, sending text messages, talking about the ending of the movie if they've seen it already. I mean, do I really need that? At home, I've got 1,000 TV channels. I've got movies that were in movie theaters as recently as a month ago. I'd be nuts. I'd be nuts to be going out. Most of the time, I stay home because I got the big screens. But then, you go to Craigslist, and you see an ad like this. This ad is absolutely amazing. It's an ad for a 50-inch high-def flat-screen Samsung television, color black. The headline says, brand new, $1,300. Of course, now you want to buy it, right? Where do you get that? The ad on Craigslist said that it's brand new and in perfect condition. And let me read you the ad. It's by a guy named William. Here's what William says. The television of my dreams. but not my girlfriend's. Says here, basically, I bought the TV for basketball season. But my girlfriend won't have something so big in our tidy little apartment. I threw away the box as a final protest, but lost the war all the same. So my loss is your gain. He says, after taxes and everything, I paid over $1,700. It's yours for $1,300 or best offer. Cash only. Serious inquiries. And he puts his actual phone number and an email address in the ad and some photos from every angle of the TV. I don't know how good the TV is just by looking at it. It certainly looks like a nice TV. There it is right there. And he actually went to the Samsung website and he copied and pasted all of the details of the specs for this TV. 13-bit video processing, 16:9 widescreen aspect ratio, 3D Y/C digital comb filter, and, of course, a bunch of stuff that he probably doesn't understand and neither do you. But they say that the TV can produce over 549 billion colors. The television of my dreams, but not my girlfriend's. There it is. Now, I need to understand this. This has nothing to do with TV. Maybe the girls can explain this to me, okay? This is a protest against sports. First of all, I think if your girlfriend is making you get rid of your TV, I say make it easy on yourself. Get a new girlfriend. Because the TV is going to be a lot better to you than your girlfriend, okay? And if your girlfriend's telling you what to do, this is a big red flag, William, okay? It's a big red flag. But that's beside the point. I mean, come on, are you telling me women like watching movies on little teeny tiny screens? No. His girlfriend hates basketball. And this is her way of twisting his balls and getting back at him for wanting to watch basketball. That's why I tell you boys who are between relationships, those of you who insist on always being in a relationship, that while you're living alone, be sure to fill your house with all the toys, all the gadgets that she would never let you have. So when somebody moves in, they have to accept it the way it is. See, my house now, if I were ever stupid enough to get into a live-in relationship now, if I were ever stupid enough to do that, I am plasmaed up the wazoo. I got plasma everywhere. Are you kidding me? My house is all plasma all the time. I am HD'd and plasmaed out. 4 floors, 7 plasma screens, and a drop-down screen. I mean, I've put plasma screens everywhere I can, and then on top of that, I added Slingbox. By the way, if you got a Slingbox, this thing is the most amazing gadget, okay? I have a Slingbox, and what the Slingbox does is it takes your television signal. It could be your cable TV box or your satellite box if you've got DirecTV or Dish Network. It can take whatever's on your home TV, whatever channels you get at home, and any other audio-video source, your DVD player, a VCR if you're still back in the Stone Age using one of those, even audio like CD players and whatever. You can put that stuff into the Slingbox, and the Slingbox will sling it to you wherever you are. So on the internet, it uses the internet to send, and this is the best part, send your TV programs to you wherever you are. Now me, I pay for every Major League Sports package there is, but guess what? When I go to friends' houses, they don't have every Major League Sports package. When I went to visit my brother, who's a big hockey fan, it was a particular game I had a bet on. I'm being honest. I had a bet on it, and he didn't have the game on his TV. I whipped out my laptop. I logged on to his home network, and I used my username and password to sign into my home TV through my Sling box. And within minutes, I'm watching a game from Tampa Bay, Florida, that I had a few bucks on, that I wouldn't have been able to watch otherwise. Didn't have to go to a sports bar. Didn't have to drive drunk. Sat in his place, popping a few cold brews, watching the game. So I've got a Sling box at home, and it not only was I able to sit in England in my hotel room watching TV from Los Angeles, I was able to sit in Tuscany this summer, you know, watching Malibu burn down. I was able to sit in Rome watching television from L.A. I saw, by the way, David Beckham's first game. Remember David Beckham? Yes, when his first game happened, I was out of the country. I was sitting in my hotel room at the St. Regis Hotel in Rome. And I was watching it on my laptop. And I was getting it from my Sling box at home. It's an amazing gadget. So I have a Sling box at home. And what I've done is you can use the Sling box to take the picture from the TV, in this case in my bedroom, and it puts it on my computer on a scalable window. So I can watch a baseball game or a football game or whatever it is that's on, any movies I've TiVo'd, I can watch them on my computer screen while I work. You have to do this when there's no chicks around because the chicks are not going to approve. They're not. Now, Dean, you have William on the line. I can't punch him in, so you'll have to punch him up on the board here. Let's get William on the line here. Is that you, William?
That's right. How you doing?
I'm doing okay. Have you ever heard our show before?
Yeah, I've heard little bits and pieces. I think you come with a big name, sir. How you
doing? No, it sounds like you needed to listen a little more. We saw your ad on Craigslist. Tell us the story. What happened over there?
Well, you know, girlfriend, boyfriend, I decided to move in with my girlfriend. I got a big 50-inch plasma screen TV, Samsung, gorgeous, my dream screen. But what can you say? It doesn't really fit in our bedroom, our living room, or anywhere. So although basketball season's right around the corner, we're going to sell it.
Well, you could mount it on the wall.
Yeah, we could knock it on the wall, but I think we just want something a little smaller. My girlfriend.
No, we don't want something a little smaller. Wait a minute. She wants something a little smaller.
You caught me there. You caught the BS machine that I'm covering for my girlfriend. What can I say? It's her place. I'm moving into it. I got to make it amicable. She's screaming in the background. Are you listening?
I have a feeling she screams in the background a lot.
Yeah, she's a good screamer, but we love that about her, don't we?
No, we don't. And I don't think even you do.
Well, before we move on to therapy, what did you want to? Did you want to buy my TV?
Well, certainly looks like a good deal there, William, but that really wasn't what I called about. What I called about was the fact I'm trying to find out why chicks object to big screen TVs. And I don't think it's because they object to electronics. I think your girlfriend doesn't want you watching basketball.
Isn't that funny? Because she is more into North Carolina basketball than I am. What can I say?
Well, why wouldn't you want a big screen TV?
I don't know. I've been trying to figure that out myself.
Because she's, you know why? Because she's got her, yeah, she's got your balls in her purse. That's why. She's showing you who the boss is over there.
You're right. I'm a pansy. What can I say?
How did you become such a pansy?
Well, thank you.
Now, I'm asking you how you became such a pansy. I mean, that's got to be great sex. I mean, this has got to be incredible.
Wait, do you know my girlfriend?
I'm asking you because you wouldn't tolerate this otherwise.
No, I probably wouldn't tolerate it otherwise. I mean, I've just moved in. I've had the TV all of a few months.
And did you buy the TV before you moved in or after?
Now let's see. I bought it about a month before I moved in, and I moved in just less than a month ago.
And did you ever consider maybe that's a red flag? Maybe you should live in your place and she should live in her place.
You're right. It's probably a big red flag. But you know how these things go, or do you? Wait a second. Do you live alone, sir? Because if you do, you probably have multiple plasma screens.
Well, it's funny you mentioned that. Before you went on the air, I explained that I've got seven of them in my home. I live in the Hollywood Hills. I've got 4 floors. I've got 7 plasma screens. And in my master bedroom, in addition to the stripper pole, remember those days, William? Remember?
In addition
to the stripper pole, I have got a 9-foot drop-down HD screen with an HD projector TV. So you've got the porn 9 feet wide and a stripper pole. Now that's a home.
So not only am I in the wrong business, but I have a live-in girlfriend that's got my balls in a sling. However, I do get sex every night. So there's probably a trade-off, because while you have a stripper pole, unless you're stripping on it, I don't know that there's somebody stripping on that pole.
But there are just some nights when you want to sit home alone and watch ESPN, aren't there? Come on.
Oh, goodness.
Remember ESPN?
I do remember ESPN.
Do you remember the days of ESPN?
Oh, goodness.
Do you remember that music?
You know what I'm watching now, Tom? I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. It's a new up and coming indie thing. It's called Havoc TV. Have you heard about this?
No.
ESPN Kid Brother. Oh goodness! It's music and sports. That way you get a whole thing, and it's the younger generation. It's going on. It's going online. It's got the web community going crazy. Now you get to slam on people. If you should be on Havoc.
I want to go down memory lane with you here, William, for a moment.
Back to the days when we had strippers.
Are you ready to get on memory lane with me?
Let's go.
Are you ready?
Let's do it.
No, I'm dead serious. I want to take you down memory lane. I want to take you to a place you haven't been in a long time.
Okay.
Now, you might shed a tear here. I just want to take you down memory lane.
I've been pretty emotional this holiday season. Don't make me cry too hard now.
Well, I'm dead serious. We're going to bring you down memory lane right now. Those were the days. Remember those days?
Tom, I can't take it anymore. You're messing me up.
You know, you could drive your girlfriend insane. Just put this on the speakerphone.
Speaker.
Remember the days when that music would come on and the vacuum cleaner would get turned on? Remember that?
Oh, goodness. Those were the days. I shouldn't play the song for my girlfriend. She'll start stripping.
No, she won't start stripping. She's gonna go crazy if she hears that music. You know, women across America hear that music, and the vacuum cleaners start coming out of the closet about 1 o'clock on Sunday. Your girl loves that music? Well, how good would it sound on a 50-inch plasma TV? Come on! All I'm trying to tell you here is, back here in the real world with the real men, this is the music we listen to on Sunday, okay? That's what we got out there.
That's right, and I'm going to help any one of these Tom Likas boys buy this TV. If they call me up in the next 24 hours, show up at my place with cash, I'll knock $50 off. That means you guys just Tom Likas $50 discount.
All right, William, will you hang on the phone so we can take some calls here?
No problem, Tom, but I'm building a bookshelf right now, so...
You build a bookshelf? Why don't you put a TV on it?
That's a brilliant idea. That's what I've been trying to do.
What are you doing?
let's get some callers, Tom.
All right. Hang on. He's already a professional talk show guest. Look at this. All right, hang on there. We're going to get back to William. We're going to take calls for William, and in case you're just tuning in... Oh, baby. William's ad appears on Craigslist. He's selling his 50-inch HD flat-screen Samsung television. It's all black. He says it's brand new and in perfect condition. He calls it the television of my dreams, but not my girlfriend's. His girlfriend is making him get rid of his flat-screen TV. What do you think about that?
Tom Likas. 1-800-5800-TOM. Tom Likas.
I totally agree with you that women can be attention whores, especially for the fact that I live in the city of attention whores, Los Angeles.
We invented attention whoring here.
The Tom Likas Show.
The Tom Likas Show at 1-800-5800-TOM. William, who's with us right now, placed an ad on Craigslist. He's looking to sell his 50-inch plasma screen because his girlfriend's making him get rid of it. Mario on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello, Tom.
Hi, Mario.
How you doing?
Great.
This guy is a complete pussy and he needs to get his balls reattached. I mean, how can you let your girlfriend get rid of, like, tell you to get rid of your TV? I mean, it's your TV. You bought it. You own it. You do whatever the hell you want with it. She doesn't agree with it. Get out. Find a new girlfriend, like you said.
I appreciate that.
He needs to get his balls reattached and get rid of that bitch. Dump that bitch.
Tell me where I can send the therapy check.
Tell me where what?
Where I can send you my therapy check.
Dude, you really need to get rid of that bitch. That's a big red flag.
By the way, Mario.
Listen to Tom. He's telling you the truth.
Mario, you hear the girlfriend in the background there? She's yelling during this whole call.
Dude, let me call her a bitch. She's a bitch. Get rid of her before it gets worse.
Bitch is all you got? I could come up with 20 better, and she's my girlfriend. That's all you, that bitch? You got to respond that. Let's see.
That's a big red flag. What she's telling you?
I'll take your slander. But until then, buy my TV, Mario.
I'm not going to buy your TV. But you really need to get rid of her. That's a big. It's only going to get worse, like I said. She wants to control your life, and later on, you're going to see and you're going to say, I should have listened to Tom.
And Mario, right, Tom, damn, you know,
later on throughout the year, and they call you back and say, I should have listened to you, Tom. This is what he's going to do.
Exactly. Like so many others, Mario, but I thank you for that. Let me get Mark on here. Mark on the Tom Likas Show with William. Hello.
William, what the hell's wrong with you, man? That TV will last longer than your chick, dude.
Listen to that. It will last a long time for whoever's buying it. Samsung gives a year warranty, baby. But here's my question. Are there no men out there that actually have healthy, conscious relationships and capable of anything other than a masculine adoration of large screens television? I mean, I love this thing, but I got no complex. I don't need to replace some lack of size with a greater
Listen to that. He says that guys who buy big screen TVs are trying to make up for a lack of size downstairs. What do you think of that, Mark?
Well, Tom,
I've been married since 99. I have 4 plasmas myself. My wife went with me to go pick them out, and since the rooms are themed, she built the custom cabinets for them. Now, what your chick is doing, I have no clue. It's a 50-inch television. It's not that big, bro. In the scheme of things, it's not that big. You could fit it in a corner if you wanted to. I think you want to, but she doesn't want to. What are you selling it for? Are you going to downsize it, or are you just get rid of it totally?
I told you, if somebody calls me right here and right now from the Tom Likas, I'll give it to her or give it away for $12.50 because I'm just that big of a fan of the Tom Likas Show.
Let me, by the way, while we, I got to ask you this question, Mark. This Thursday night, you got the Packers and the Cowboys playing. Are you going to be sitting out in the garage watching that game or some bar somewhere? Where are you going to watch that game, Mark?
I could watch it in 4 different rooms. I watch it in my bedroom, my computer room. I could watch it in my game room. You know, I could watch it in the living room. I don't know where I'm going to be, but I'm going to be in my house watching it on my TV.
Nice. Well, I tell you, someday I'll be able to live that dream like y'all. And thank
it's not a dream.
Away.
It's not a dream, bro. You have it. It's reality. I mean, if she was a fiance, if she was a wife, I still wouldn't understand why you're getting rid of the TV. It's a beautiful television, a 50-inch Samsung. It's beautiful. I've seen them. No matter which model you got, they're beautiful. I'm pretty sure it's hotter than your chick.
You tell me.
Mark, thank you very much for that. Let me get Ryan on here. Ryan, you're on with William on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello, Tom. How are you doing, my friend?
Great.
Hey, William, I would just like to thank you for taking such a bitch like that off the market so no one else gets stuck with her. And I'd like to bring my dog over so he could just watch you roll over. You could teach him some tricks, and he'll just lay there and take it. You can't believe you're letting a team.
That's a good one. Dang. Let's do it. Let's have a rip on William moment. But tell you what, guys, I'm still just trying to sell a TV, y'all. If you care this much about electronics, must be damn lonely.
Any guy that's going to sell a TV for a chick like that and let her yell at him when he's on the phone on the radio like that, bro, you got to get your balls back out of her purse and reattach them.
But it was her bitch.
You are a pussy.
The TV for me in the first place. So you guys all misunderstand the situation as best you like. But what in the end, if it wasn't for her, I wouldn't have the thing in the first place. So let's just be honest here, gentlemen. It's just a TV. I can get another one next year.
Wait. Did you say if it wasn't?
It has to do with your manlyhood of letting her tell you what to do after you just moved in. You're the man. Wear the pants, take off her skirt, and grab your balls back.
God,
you are a pussy.
Hi, Ryan. Thank you for that. I will take a break. We'll come back here with William. William's girlfriend is making him sell his 50-inch Samsung HD TV. What do you think about that?
Likas. 1-800-5800-TOM. 1-800-5800-866. Party like a king with Tom and King's legend Luke Robitaille. Saturday, December 8th, in the exclusive Staples Center Grand Reserve Club. Go to blowmeuptom.com for details. It's the Tom Likas Show.
Yeah, from Hollywood, the Tom Likas Show at 1-800-5800-TOM. We are here with William, who placed a posting on Craigslist. He is trying to sell his 50-inch plasma TV that he got to watch basketball because his girlfriend, who he recently moved in with, wants him to get rid of it. No, told him to get rid of it. And so he is. 1-800-5800-TOM, that is our telephone number. Let's continue with your telephone calls. Let's say hello here to David on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hi, Tom. How are you doing today?
I'm great.
First of all, I'd just like to say it's an honor and a pleasure speaking to you. Now, to Williams. Dude, get your balls out of her purse. Keep that TV. Dump that bitch, man. I'm 20 years old. I'm about to turn 21. I have my own 47-inch HD TV, and I love it more than I love anything in the world. A girl could never replace that TV, dude. Just dump that bitch, man. Just take it. Just dump that. Not worth it.
What do you think about that?
Tom, I can't wait. Three more of these guys on here, and I'll just have to slit my own wrists in fear of all men. Come on. Guys, do we not have anything more than a seventh-grade education?
Let me wait a minute. Well, first of all, why do you assume the people who disagree with you have a seventh-grade education?
Maybe they're just real men with big balls.
Like,
balls. Man, have we not evolved? Come on, guys. It's just a TV. This is a relationship. You can buy it or not. It doesn't matter to me. Go on Craigslist. Willie Watts. It's all done.
Yeah, but wait a minute. What they want to know is, you bought this TV before you moved in. Your girlfriend could have said, hey, you can't move in if you got a TV, but you moved in, they brought the TV, and now she makes you get rid of it.
Yeah. So, what's the big deal?
Well, because she's making you do something.
Oh, goodness. Tom, we're all a little bit more educated than that in this life, this world.
Oh, so, in other words, educated people are pussy-whipped. Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm saying if you believe anything is that simple in black and white, then you've got to be someone.
All right, well, give us all what we're missing here. What are we missing?
Tom, I don't need to, man. It's simple. I move into a place with a girl. The TV doesn't fit. We sell. We got a little style here. We got a good little pad. I'm selling it. So if somebody wants to buy it, $1,300.
Well, I'm looking at the pictures here. No offense. It's not that you live in a dump or anything, but I'm looking at the pictures here. It doesn't look like you live in a museum or anything. Just an average apartment.
Well, you know, when I have a little bit more space for a stripper pole and four plasmas, I'll think about that investment. But until then, I'm going to just let go.
So where were you living before? The Getty Museum?
Oh, good one. No.
Well, we
had it was all booked.
Did you have more space at your last place?
Yeah, substantially.
Why'd you move into her place?
It was the right time. It was the right thing to do.
Tom, can I ask something else?
Why didn't you have her move into your place if you had to live with her?
I didn't have to do anything, Tom. I still don't. I'm choosing to do this. I'm deciding my own
action. Why didn't you choose to have her move into your bigger, more spacious place?
Tom, it's been a pleasure, but the way I'm going to dignify all your questions and all your listeners right now is to end this conversation. We're going around in circles. You guys are all of one side, I'm of another. If anybody wants to steal of a television, all they have to do is Craigslist. 50-inch Samsung television, no problem at all. Yours for $1,300. Otherwise, you can call in the Tom Likas Show and get my number from Dino. Thanks a lot, gentlemen. Have a great day.
Oh, look at that.
Hey, if you need a little help, no problem.
I don't need any help. I don't need any help from a guy who's pussy whipped. I don't. He hung up on us, folks. Let's go to Scott on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hey, Tom. Good evening. This guy, there's plenty of things he's not telling you. He's holding out. They're strapped for cash, or she's going to move him out of there as soon as the TV's out of there. She's having buyer's remorse, and the first thing to go is the floor mats, which is his TV.
I agree with you. Who knows what that money would be used for, you know.
He's going to buy a cat in a litter box and a scratch pole, and he's going to be out on the sitting on the corner of the bed. He's going to be out.
If your girlfriend tells you you need to get rid of your TV, the real truth is you need to get rid of your girlfriend.
Completely unacceptable. There's no way in heck I would ever take that. If that came out of anybody's mouth, they'd be out the door. In fact, I was shopping today, and I don't know about his 50-inch plasma. I'm looking at the 58 Panasonic, one for the living room, and, you know, why not one for the bedroom? Maybe his 50 will go in my garage, so when I'm wrenching on toys, I can throw a little adult entertainment on the wall in the garage.
You haven't lived until you've seen porn on the big plasma screen, I'm telling you.
I'm looking forward to it, but, you know, I don't know what he's thinking. There's something he's not telling.
Something. All right, Scott.
All right, thank you.
Thank you for that. It's Jordan on the Tom Likas Show. William hung up on us, but here we are.
How you doing, Tom?
I'm okay.
Well, it's too bad he hung up because I install these things for a living. On a commercial basis, I also do home install. And I got to tell you, a flat screen does one thing that a steady girlfriend doesn't do. It entertains. Okay? And this guy is out of his mind, and I bet you the next thing that's going to go is the next car he purchases.
Yeah, probably so. Now, you can, by the way, I've hired professionals like you to work in my own home. That screen can be mounted on the wall like a picture, right?
Anything. Any way they want. If they want it mounted, they want it on a stand, on a desk, whatever it is, it doesn't take up that much room.
It'll take up less space than one of those conventional tube TVs, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And they're getting thinner by the year. Plus, you picked a Samsung. I'd probably go Panasonic, like the last caller. That's a nice screen, by the way.
Yeah, I have one at home.
Me too. I have a couple. I got to tell you, I started listening to you a couple years back, and I dumped the girl that I was with and just followed your rules. The money I saved paid for those screens.
Love it. And that's really what guys should do. Dump that bitch and then take the money you save and plasma the hell out of your house.
Absolutely. Plasma, projector, surround sound. I mean, it's all entertainment. It's all for fun.
I got them. Yeah. How many people have 4 subwoofers in their home?
I have 3.
Uh-huh. That's what I'm talking about.
That's, you know, really, and honestly, you know, he's going to make the decision whether anybody says anything, and he's going to regret it because in the end, he's going to miss watching some HD quality TV.
No doubt about it.
It's a shame. Thank you very much, Tom. Can you blow me up?
Yes, indeed I can. 1-800-5800-TOM. It's Jim on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Professor Tom.
Yes.
Hey, glad to be in the classroom. Hey, calling because I've been listening to this on the way back in the car. And hate to tell you, I've been married for quite a while now, but I'm going to tell this guy, my wife, you know, she lets me get what I want. She says if it makes me happy, then it's good. She keeps me happy. She likes it. If this chick is making this guy sell his TV this early in, like, what, a month in, then it's time to cut her loose and go back, keep the TV, and get out.
Well, that's what I say. Any chick who starts telling me what to do, I just get a new chick. Just replace them.
No, I mean, if he's wanting to sell it that bad, I'll tell him what. If he paid the shipping to me in Texas, I'll keep it for him. And as soon as in a month or two, when she moves out, if he'll pay the shipping back, he won't have to sell it. I'll send the sucker back. I mean, good grief. If she's making him give it up that early, like I said, I know how you feel about marriage. I waited until I was in my mid-30s before I married. It's been one time where we're going good. But she likes it if it makes me happy and it keeps me content. She's not against it. I mean, hey, you're not out there running around. She should keep her mouth shut. Keep the TV.
No doubt about it. Danny on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hey, what's going on, Tom? It's an honor.
Thank you.
Until I heard him just, pussy out and hang up, I was willing to compromise. Coming from a college student, I've seen the need to compromise with girls, to get them into your room, if you know what I mean. But other than that, dude, that guy, grab your nuts back, man. Get the TV. Dude, if I could afford a TV, if I wasn't paying for school, I'd have a plasma TV. I wouldn't trade that for any bitch in the world.
I'm amazed he's giving his TV up. I am amazed.
I am, too. I get, when are you going to miss lonely nights when your bitch is on top of you and you want to watch the TV while she, services.
By the way, this has nothing to do with television. It has nothing to do with electronics.
Right.
Nothing. Nothing.
Dude, she's power tripping. She needs to back up.
I mean, that to me, that's what this is all about. Sonia on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hi, Tom.
Hi.
I have a comment. I would like to let you know that not all women are like that.
No one said all women are like that, but those who are should be dumped.
I personally have a Sony 60-inch TV, high definition, digital,
all, right, nice.
All the bells and whistles, picture in picture, by the way.
Really?
And I would not give up my TV for anybody. As a matter of fact, I wouldn't even give up the remote for a man. And real men do not call women bitches.
Oh, no. When they are bitches, you call them bitches.
Well, they should be educated enough to be able to get their.
It has nothing to do with education. Some women are bitches. Some women. Use
that
word on the air. How's that? You can't use that word on the air. It's illegal. You can't use it. You and your filthy mouth. Clearly, you're a bitch. 1-800-5800-TOM is our telephone number. It's Tehran. On the Tom Likas Show, hello.
What up, Tom?
Not much, Tehran.
I got two things to say. First of all, that guy's a pussy, flat out. And number two, if he had a bullpen, he can kick it to the curb and bring in a new girl.
That's right.
And then my third thing is that, go ahead, take me out O.J. style, because he needs to kill that bitch like O.J. did.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Look, I do agree that O.J. killed Nicole Brown Simpson. That part I agree with. That's where I get off the boat. 1-800-5800-TOM. It's Chris on the Tom Likas Show. Hello. Are you there, Chris?
I'm like the show.
Yes.
Hi, I'd like to comment on a guy with a TV problem, a girlfriend problem.
Go ahead.
If that chick is, if it's a true power play and she's trying to either give him or her, him an ultimatum on either the TV or her, then yeah, he needs to make the decision on keeping the TV and losing her. But if it's another problem where he really truly loves the chick, then maybe he needs to stay with her and get rid of the TV. That's my opinion of the matter.
All right. Thank you for that. Let me just squeeze Randy in here. I got 30 seconds, Randy.
Hey, that guy, that last caller about the screen TV, he's going to make somebody a good wife. We know where there's a pass in the family on that deal.
Our email address is my name. It's Tom at blowmeuptom.com. If you got that, Tom at blowmeuptom.com.
The Tom Likas Show.